The third attempt often proves successful. If that statement is true, after two failed attempts with Starship, the upcoming launch is anticipated to be the one that finally succeeds. This isn't just a standard test flight. It's a tipping point that could potentially impact Starship's future trajectory, impact NASA's Artemis program, and reshape the timeline of humanity's aspirations for space exploration. How SpaceX will make its mark on history with this upcoming flight? Let's dive deeper on today's episode of NR Studio. With each space Starship launch, we experience that familiar mix of excitement and apprehension, watching intently and fervently, hoping the vehicle will successfully complete its mission. However, the last two flights have been marred by a sense of disappointment stemming from unforeseen complications. On January 16, Flight 7 marked the inaugural block to launch, which ultimately culminated in a catastrophic fire and an unplanned rapid disassembly. On March 6, Flight 8 suffered a catastrophic upper stage explosion due to a fuel leak that disabled its engines, leading to a mass of debris and loss of communication with mission control. So on this occasion, Elon Musk and SpaceX are putting their entire bet on Flight 9. This implies that they are under immense pressure to demonstrate their capacity to fix the issues discovered in the previous two flights and finally achieve the mission's critical objectives. The upcoming launch will mark SpaceX's third utilization of the Block 2 hardware, which represents the latest evolution of the upper stage. Beyond simply confirming important goals such as achieving orbital flight and a successful landing, the mission serves as a significant reliability assessment for SpaceX collaborators, which include NASA, the Department of Defense, the U.S. government, investors, and the aerospace sector. A successful flight will also reinforce Starship's significance in future missions, most notably Artemis 3, which aspires to return humans to the lunar surface by 2027. When is Flight 9 scheduled to depart, and how will it differ from its predecessors? Recent FCC filings indicate that the launch window will begin on April 7, 2025, and will extend to October 7th of that year. However, the fundamental insight to be gleaned from this discussion is not the conclusion date. April 7th appears to be SpaceX's first serious launch target. Some may be skeptical about the FCC filing, especially given the ongoing FAA updates. However, if history is any indicator, this timeline is very accurate. In the case of Flight 8, the FCC had set a launch date of February 2nd, while SpaceX had originally targeted a launch date of February 26th, just 2 days later. Certainly, while the delays have postponed the actual launch to March 6th, this merely underscores the remarkable reliability of the FCC timeline. Should SpaceX indeed target early April for Flight 9, they are exhibiting a commendable cadence in their launch schedule. There is no reason for alarm. Having previously addressed the challenges encountered by Starship during Flight 8, along with the enhancements implemented, we can now relax and observe the forthcoming test phase with assurance. Now, let us delve into the factors that render this flight historic. There are four principal factors that contribute to its distinction. Initially, Booster 14 will supplant Booster 16 for this particular launch. Initially, SpaceX intended to deploy Booster 16 and ship 35 for the ninth test flight. Booster 16 underwent its own preparation protocol. However, it encountered certain delays. For instance, it remained at the Massey testing facility for a duration of 3 weeks following the conclusion of cryogenic testing on March 1st. This protracted duration may have been intended to observe and rectify issues stemming from prior flights. However, at this pace, it fails to satisfy the criteria for launch preparedness. At present, Booster 14 is optimally positioned to facilitate an expedited turnaround. Flight 7 executed a flawlessly controlled landing, positioning it as the prime contender for subsequent reuse. Crucially, on April 1st, it was ascended to the orbital launch mount in preparation for the imminent tests, with prospects of executing a static fire test at the earliest opportunity. Consequently, Booster 14 will undoubtedly be utilized. This development is significant as SpaceX demonstrates that Starship operates as a fully reusable vehicle, substantially reducing launch costs to their minimal threshold, thereby posing a formidable challenge for any prospective competitors to surpass. Secondly, Booster 14 will not be landing on Mechazilla. Conversely, it will be arriving in the ocean. While official information is not yet available, there are two compelling reasons supporting this situation. It is possible that the launch tower is currently undergoing enhancements or maintenance, indicating that it is not prepared for use at this moment. Such an outcome would not be unexpected. SpaceX consistently refines its hardware to enhance performance and efficiency. Alternatively, SpaceX is concentrating on evaluating the vessel's performance in this mission. They likely seek to assess its performance during re-entry at a steeper angle, as well as the resilience of the engines under adverse conditions. If that is indeed the situation, capturing Booster 14 with Mechazilla is not the foremost priority. Allowing it to plunge into the ocean streamlines the process. Circumventing the complexities of tower timing enables a greater emphasis on refining the ship's re-entry and landing. Okay, third, this will mark Starship's first successful orbital flight. Despite 8 test flights, Starship has yet to complete a true orbital mission. As a result, SpaceX is ramping up its efforts to achieve this milestone on Flight 9, especially considering the increased competition in this year's space race. Notably, in January, Blue Origin drew a lot of attention when its New Glenn rocket surprisingly achieved orbital flight during its maiden launch. This remarkable achievement marked a significant milestone for the company, which, in its 2-year history, had yet to successfully complete an orbital mission. Although subsequent attempts to land the vehicle were unsuccessful, it did achieve orbital insertion using a methane-powered rocket. This technology, which is similar to Starship, has put Blue Origin in much closer competition with SpaceX. Ultimately, this mission will mark Starship's first foray into orbit for the purpose of delivering cargo, specifically Starlink satellites. Successfully carrying cargo, such as Starlink, into orbit and completing a mission would demonstrate that Starship has transcended its status as a mere prototype, indicating that the Block 2 version is indeed prepared for actual operational missions. In October 2024, Musk commented via Twitter that the next generation of Starlink satellites, which are so large that only Starship can launch them, will provide a tenfold increase in bandwidth and, due to their reduced altitude, will also provide lower latency. He has previously indicated that Starship is ready to replace the Falcon 9 for satellite launch missions. This is especially important as newer satellite iterations, such as Starlink version 3, are getting larger. Flight 9 will demonstrate that Starship is fully equipped to take on the role of facilitating Starlink's expansion. No doubt the realization of all of this hinges on the successful completion of the Ship 35 mission. While we all aspire to achieve success, achieving it is still an uncertain prospect. Flight the 9th of May still face obstacles. What are the implications of failure? The third incident would prompt another FAA investigation, similar to the ones that followed Flights 7 and 8. The investigation into Flight 7 continued for several weeks, culminating in its approval of its findings on March 31st. The underlying issues stem from an unanticipated vibration that caused damage to the propulsion system. SpaceX nevertheless proceeded with Flight 8 on March 6th. However, it failed at a nearly identical point in the mission. This intensified the onus on SpaceX to improve its vehicle design and avoid potential regulatory setbacks in future launches. If Flight 9 had any difficulties, it could inadvertently impact Artemis 3 in 2027 due to stricter FAA regulations. That's an aspect SpaceX can't afford to ignore. As you may know, in 2021, NASA awarded SpaceX a landmark $2.89 billion contract to design Starship's Human Landing System, HLS, for the Artemis missions, which aimed to facilitate humanity's return to the lunar surface for the first time since Apollo 17 in 1972. With merely 2 years remaining until the lunar landing, do you believe SpaceX can effectively refine the Human Landing System, HLS, within the timeline, despite the FAA's ongoing delays in their test launches? The response is affirmative. Such delays were anticipated. In December 2023, NASA conducted a comprehensive evaluation of the timeline, establishing February 2028 as the anticipated date for the readiness of Starship, accompanied by a 70% degree of confidence. The confidence level articulated by the Government Accountability Office, GAO, derives from a meticulous examination of costs, schedules, risks, and uncertainties. Nevertheless, this implies that the target for February 2028 lags a complete year behind NASA's existing timeline for Artemis 3, set for mid-2027. Furthermore, with a 70% confidence level, there remains a 30% likelihood that Starship may not be operational by that date, or potentially even thereafter. Moreover, China's Long March 9th, a rocket engineered to rival Starship, is advancing remarkably. supported by government initiatives and unencumbered by the stringent launch regulations imposed by the FAA, SpaceX stands a significant chance of surpassing the United States in the quest to return to the moon. Moreover, a subsequent failure may begin to erode investor confidence. Undoubtedly, the reliability of Falcon 9, the accomplishments of Dragon, and the revenue generated from Starlink and Tesla have afforded SpaceX a robust financial foundation to continue its progressive endeavors. However, should the setbacks continue to accumulate, despite the robust support from formidable allies such as NASA, the Department of Defense, and influential figures like Trump, it's conceivable that even SpaceX may find it challenging to evade the mounting pressures. Consequently, it is imperative for SpaceX to elevate Flight 9 to a groundbreaking milestone. Indeed, SpaceX has encountered a series of setbacks in the past and teetered on the brink of bankruptcy. Reflecting on the nascent period of Falcon 1, it is noteworthy that from 2006 to 2008, SpaceX experienced three consecutive launch failures and faced severe financial constraints. In a 2012 interview, Musk disclosed that following the third unsuccessful launch, the company had barely enough capital remaining for a final endeavor, amounting to approximately $5 million. In a post on X, he revealed that he was on the brink of financial instability, resorting to borrowing funds from friends to cover his rent. John Edwards, one of the leading engineers at SpaceX during that period, articulated a quote that proved pivotal in enabling Elon Musk and the entire organization to recuperate. "Perseverance is essential. Following the challenges encountered during Falcon 1 Flight 3, we discovered that the most profound struggles often precede the arrival of brighter days. Maintain your determination and perseverance. Success is within our reach." Indeed, they accomplished that. That last-minute success did more than merely salvage SpaceX. It secured a contract with NASA valued at $1.6 billion, establishing the groundwork for the current empire and propelling Musk to the status of the world's wealthiest individual. The hard-won success of Falcon 1 laid the foundation for Falcon 9, which has emerged as the most reliable spacecraft in the realm of space exploration, boasting nearly 500 successful launches and an unparalleled record of reusability. In a similar, or perhaps even greater way, Musk has the financial wherewithal to take Starship to new heights without the worry of spending. Starship Flight 9 merely marked the beginning of an entirely new iteration of the spacecraft. Prospectively, if all goes smoothly, Flight 10 could potentially happen in mid-May or even earlier. If Ship 35 successfully launches and re-enters its satellite, culminating in a splashdown in the ocean, it could then be reused for additional upper stage testing. Additionally, given that Booster 16 has successfully completed its cryogenic testing, it continues to be a strong contender for Flight 10. Nonetheless, Ship 36 is progressing at an impressive pace. On February 13th, the latest update showed that the nose cone and payload section were equipped with capture points, suggesting that it may be the first Starship to be captured by the tower. In early March, the rear section switched to MB2, with installation of the PES dispenser beginning on March 13th. Currently at the central workstation at Starbase, Texas, and nearly fully loaded, S-36 appears to be a strong candidate for a mid-May launch. In my estimation, it is very likely that SpaceX will substantially increase the payload mass for Flight 10. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thanks for your support.